Welcome to today's tutorial. My name is Oku Kenneth. I'll be looking at physics, specifically force equilibrium. Now, of course, we know that force is that changes the motion, or the force is that changes the position of a body with respect to time from one point to another. Now, under this case, under force equilibrium, we are looking at the static condition of forces. So under this particular topic, we will see what happens when a particular force is being applied along a direction and the reaction that is produced. Now let's consider case one. When we consider this case, a flat body or an horizontal surface having a body of mass m being placed. Normally, since this body is mass m, it must be measured in kg. Automatically, it means that the weight of the body must act downward. If the weight of the body acts downward, it becomes W equal to what? Mg. We all know that. Now, for this weight to act downward, remember, the condition we consider is a static condition, that is an equilibrium condition. Therefore, we say that there must be an upward force to balance the weight coming downward. That upward force is known as the normal reaction R. In this case, since we know that upward force must be equal to downward force, therefore we could say that my R must be equal to W and both must be equal to what? Mg. Okay? Now, if this case is well taken note of, what if I apply a force? Let's say I want to move this particular body from this position to another position. For me to do that, I must put an applied force. Let's say this is an applied force F. For this body to move from this point to another point, after applying this force, there must be an opposite reaction. That opposite reaction will be known as a frictional force. Now, since we know that summation along the x-axis must be equal to zero, this is the force moving along the positive x direction. So I can say that positive F must be equal, or probably positive F minus negative FR must be equal to what? Zero. But if I consider the fact that this my force is a pulling force P, I could therefore say a pulling force P minus the frictional force equal to zero. Therefore, pulling force equals frictional force, which is equal to what last? Mu W. Okay? So we know this for sure. Or probably, since we know that the frictional force is equal to mu R, because my W is equal to R and both of them are equal to Mg, we could therefore say that my pulling force P is equal to frictional force and both are equal to mu Mg. So this condition is taken note of. Okay? So this becomes the first condition that we consider. Therefore, since pulling force is equal to Fr, what is my pulling force? My pulling force is equal to what? Ma. But my frictional force is equal to what? Mu Mg. Taking note of this condition that P is equal to Fr, we could say that Ma is equal to mu Mg. Mass, we cancel mass, of course. Therefore, we say that A is equal to mu G divided by side by G. This, we cancel this, then my mu is equal to A all over what? G. So for this condition alone, we take note that our R is equal to W equal to Mg. My pulling force is equal to frictional force, which is equal to mu W, owing to the fact that W is equal to R and both are equal to Mg. Then this condition is established. What is this mu? My mu stands for what? The coefficients of what? Friction. Depending on the type of friction, friction could be static, friction could be dynamic. It is static when it is just about to move. It is dynamic when it is already on motion. So, one thing we must also take note is that the frictional force, or this coefficient of friction, is totally dependent on the nature of the surface. That is why we say that for a smooth surface, my coefficient of friction is equal to zero because it is perfectly smooth. Stop. What if I have that same ground level or that same surface, but this time around, okay, we still have the body of mass m in kg. Of course, my weight will act downward. The direction of my weight is along the negative y direction. So my W must always be equal to mg. Normally, I must have my normal reaction, okay? Now, but what if I am trying to move this particular body not along the positive x-axis this time around, but along an inclined angle, okay? Now look at it here. If I should place, or I'm trying to place this body, or I'm trying to make this body to move along an inclined angle theta with a pulling force, what happens? This is it. Simply because of this angular resolution, we say that this particular component P has two components. And what are those two components? The vertical component and the horizontal component. What will be the vertical component? Resolving along the vertical axis. If I resolve along the vertical axis, it will make this my theta to open. When my theta is opening, it is giving sine. When my theta is closing, it is giving cos. So this will become P sine theta. But when I resolve it along the horizontal axis, it will become P cos theta. Now remember the condition we consider. We are considering a what? An equilibrium, that is a static condition. Now if I have my frictional force definitely acting along this direction, what do you think will happen? Upward force must be equal to the downward force. What is my upward force? My upward forces there are three. My upward forces there are two, but my total vertical forces are three. How are they three? I have the normal reaction, I have the resolved component along the vertical, then I have my weight acting downward. What are the two upward forces? My reaction and my resolved component. Therefore, I could say that R plus P sine theta must be equal to what class? W. Therefore, this condition is well established. Now, having taken note of this condition, what happens to the horizontal resolution? In my horizontal, what and what do I have? Certainly, I have this moving along the negative x, and I have the resolved component along the positive x. Therefore, I could say that positive x, that is P cos theta minus FR, will be equal to what? Zero. What happens when I transfer this over to this place? P cos theta will be equal to what? My frictional force. Dividing both sides by cos theta, this will cancel this. Therefore, my pulling force is equal to my frictional force all over what? Cos theta. If this condition is well established, let us quickly recall this equation. From this last equation, I told you that R plus P sine theta is equal to W. Therefore, R plus, what is my P now? FR all over cos theta multiplied by sine theta equal to what? W. R plus FR open bracket sine theta over cos theta will be equal to W. From trigonometry, what is sine theta over cos theta? That will give us what? Tan theta. Therefore, R plus tan theta will be equal to what? W. So these are the conditions necessary for this case. We consider the force that is moving upward. But what if the force is moving along this direction? We make it of the principle of transmissibility. What does it state? It states that a force can be transferred from one point to another, provided that it acts on the same line of action. Now, what is that line of action? This is what I will do. All I have to do is to draw an imaginary line that can transmit this force from this point to this point. So you can see that this, my force along this direction, has been transferred to this point successfully. If this is angle theta, all I have to do is to take the alternate angle. What angle is alternate to this? This is the angle alternate to this. So if this is force, a pulling force, this will also be my pulling force of the same magnitude, because it was this force that was transferred to this point. Now, at this point, all I have to do is to resolve. If I resolve along this axis, I'm going to have minus P, because my theta is closing, it will take cos theta. And if I resolve along this direction, I'm going to have minus P sine theta, because it is along the negative y direction. So we take note, upward force must be equal to downward force. What are the upward forces? I have R as an upward force, just R. So I say R equal to, what are my downward forces? I have W, or not just W, I have what? Minus P sine what? Theta. So this condition exists. Now let's see for the horizontal, what is happening there? I have resolved this along this direction. Of course, my frictional force will be along this direction too. Therefore, observing this critically, what do you think happens? I could therefore say minus P cos theta minus FR is equal to what? Zero. Therefore, FR is equal to P minus P cos what? Theta as a case. Okay, so when you get to this point, it is almost the same like what we did in the last case, apart from this principle of what, transmissibility. Now let us consider the final case. This is the final case, an inclined plane. If we consider an inclined plane at an angle theta and we have a body of mass m, certainly, considering this case, what happens? If we know that this is a body of mass m, my weight will definitely act at the center of the body, because that would be the point of that, because that would be the center of gravity. My weight is equal to what, last mg. Now knowing that, I know that my normal reaction must be perpendicular to the plane, so this would be my normal reaction r. Okay, now this theta is equal to this theta if I should apply similarity between triangles. Therefore, I could say that if I'm trying to pull this my body upward with the pulling force p, there must be an opposite frictional reaction causing it not to move. When I resolve, this can be resolved along this particular point, and at this point, I'm going to have the resolved part of W along theta to be W cos theta, because my theta is what, closing. Considering this case now, what are the upward force? I therefore know that as regards this case, my R must be equal to what, W cos theta, because the upward force must be equal to the downward force, and this downward force is the resolved component of my W. Now also, this same W could be resolved along this direction. If my W is resolved along the direction, it becomes the force that becomes parallel to the plane. What is happening to this theta? My theta is opening, so because it is opening, it becomes sine. Therefore, this becomes W sine theta, which will be the force parallel to the plane, while W cos theta will be the force perpendicular to the plane. Now let us resolve horizontally. Resolving horizontally, I could say that W sine theta plus my frictional force Fr could be equal to my what, to my pulling force, because they are facing opposite towards direction. So this condition holds vividly. But then, since I know that my frictional force or my force is equal to mu r, I could say that if I divide both sides by r, this will cancel this, my mu will be equal to my force all over my r. What is the force? The force perpendicular to the plane, and this is equal to W sine theta. And what is my r? My r is equal to W cos theta. My mu could therefore be equal to mg sine theta over mg cos theta. This will cancel this. What do I have there? Mu equal to sine theta over cos theta. Therefore, my mu is equal to tan theta. So when we consider this case, we can use our mu to be equal to tan theta. So I want to believe with these few analyses, you have been able to understand resolution of force equilibrium, and you can actually apply it in your day-to-day activities, even as regards the exam you are preparing for. So stay tuned, subscribe, and get more of the video. This is Best Brain Tutorial College. Thank you. Now let's see this question to buttress my point. The question says, calculate the magnitude of the force required just to move a 20 kg object along a horizontal surface if the coefficient of friction is 0.2. So my coefficient of friction is 0.2. The first thing I will do in this case is to draw my diagram. My diagram might look like this. The body or the object is 20 kg. So I know this is 20 kg. Okay? Now, this acting downward will be the weight. I told you weight is equal to mg. Therefore, my weight is equal to 20 times 10, because my g is equal to 10. So this will be equal to 200 newton. Now what did they say we should calculate? They asked me to calculate the magnitude of the force required just to move a 20 kg object along a horizontal surface. To move it along a horizontal surface, that is, they are talking about this force, this pulling force. Now my pulling force definitely must be affected by a frictional force. Okay, now my frictional force is equal to mu mg, is it not? Therefore, my frictional force Fr will be equal to my mu, what is my mu, 0.2, times, what is my mass, 20 times 10. Of course, this is automatically equal to my W, which is the weight. So I have 20 times what, 200. What is 0.2? 0.2 is 2 over 10 times 200. 0 will cancel 0, my FR is equal to 2 times what? 20. 2 times 20 will give me what? 40 newton. But is 40 newton really my answer? Let us check. I was asked to calculate the force required to move this along this horizontal surface. But just like what I told you, if you watch, my force is along the positive x, so I have positive p, and my frictional force along the negative f, which is negative fr, both of them must be equal to zero. When I take this one over here, my positive p will be equal to fr. Therefore, my positive p, what is my fr? My fr is equal to 40. Therefore, this answer is correct both for the frictional force and the pulling force. Therefore, 40 becomes the answer to that equation.